Thank you very much, Your Honor. You're an inspiration to all of us, and to your family, and to all of those in Buffalo. Keep up the good work. Our next award is one that we provide every year. The Victim Rights Caucus honors an individual who is actually a survivor of a violent crime and has used the experience to help others who have been crime victims and who are survivors. Today, I'm honored to recognize Arian Pauls with the Ava Muriel Unsung Hero Award. Ava Muriel herself was a victim of crime, and she was a survivor. And her story was an inspiration to all of us. And so the caucus determined that we would name this award after Ava, who some of you knew. The person this year who is the recipient of the Ava Marie Unsung Hero is Arian Pauls. Arian, would you please come forward? It's a sad story, but it's an inspirational story in the sense of her ability to regain her life back. Shortly after graduating high school in 2007, Arian became a victim of human trafficking. The trafficker moved her across the state, isolated her from her family and friends, barred her from having any contact with them or the outside world. For 4 years, her trafficker forced her to have sex with strangers for money. Luckily, after those 4 years, Arian was able to escape the trafficker and start a new life. She became an advocate, like so many of you here, for human trafficking survivors. Arian uses her painful experiences to relate to other survivors, powerfully connecting with them and letting them know that they're not alone. She volunteers with Breaking the Chains in the Central Valley Justice Coalition Group. Arian is a lead victim advocate at Breaking the Chains, an organization that serves adult women who are subject to human trafficking and who are survivors. As a lead advocate, she runs a support group for adult women. Her work with groups focuses on creating an environment where women can relearn life skills, especially those that support healthy lifestyles. At the Central Valley Justice Coalition, Arian serves as a prevention educator in the My Life, My Choice program. This program works to prevent sexual exploitation with adolescent girls. Here, Arian shares her story to groups at high school age girls, educating them on the vulnerabilities and the risks that lead to human trafficking, especially as it relates to the internet. One point she focuses on is the dangers of sharing too much personal information and the deep emotions that sometimes individuals allow on social media because they're lonely. They feel they're by themselves. Noting that all too often, traffickers will exploit this information and prey on these individuals. Arian also is a volunteer with the Central Valley Justice Coalition, an instructor in human trafficking 101 classes. These classes are designed to educate people on the crime of human trafficking, and very importantly, on how to detect and report it so that our justice system and our safety net that is exhibited here can respond. Arian is a voice for so many railing against human trafficking and raising public awareness about this despicable crime. She's appeared on television to speak about human trafficking. She has shared her story in the print media. She has spoken at dinners and charity events and trainings. Arian, you are a true strength and a triumph of the human spirit. You're an inspiration for all of us. And it is with great honor that I present to you this morning with the Ava Muriel Unsung Hero Award today.
really like to thank Congressman Costa. His office and entire staff worked very diligently to ensure that I made it here today, and I think that is absolutely phenomenal. As a single parent who works a normal job, and I really appreciate that, and as well to Congressman Poe as well. Thank you so much for just creating this opportunity and a platform for all advocates and survivors. And I had the honor last night meeting the old buffaloes, so you're right, they should have came with a warning label, but that is awesome. Ann Seymour is absolutely awesome, graciously opened her home to me and hosted for dinner, and I thank you as well for that. I just want to recognize the people that are back home, my family, my support system, everybody. I wouldn't be where I am today if I didn't have the support system that I have now. Support systems for survivors, along with support systems for victims, is very, very important. Being here in Washington, D.C. has been a phenomenal experience. I was here one and only one other time back in 2009, and I was being trafficked in the streets where I could see the Capitol, I could see the monument, but I did not feel like I belonged. I did not feel like I felt like a shadow. I felt like a person who was hiding amongst all these tourists, and I felt so out of place, and I had a lot of anxiety coming here today and worried about what would I say and how can I reach these people. And yesterday I went full on tourist. Have that identity as a victim, not that identity as a survivor, but an identity as a thriver. And it is such an honor to be here to not just represent the silent and not silent voices of the Central Valley, but all of those across the country. Thank you guys so much for giving an opportunity, especially the caucus, to all of those survivors and victims. So I accept your award humbly, and I thank you all very much.
Ted, and for the rest of you, when I called Arian a couple weeks ago to make her aware that she had been presented this award, I asked her, I said, have you ever been to our nation's capital before? And she paused for a moment, and she said, yeah. She said, when I was being trafficking, I was here in 2009, and she says, and Jim, I won't tell you the horrific experiences I went through when I came to our nation's capital. For me to have an opportunity to come back as a recipient, but we had to, this is, Ted's the lawyer in our partnership, so I don't try to get into this part of it. But she had, I don't know what the technical legal term would be called, but a leftover, that's how I would, I'm a farm boy, warrant for her arrest here in the District of Columbia for prostitution. And she was fearful that if she came back to receive the award, that, you know, as a result of fact, when she was here, she was held captive by this trafficker, that the system might respond inappropriately. So with Annie's good help and the team here, we were able to erase that warrant. So that Arian can come here and have, as a citizen, enjoy our nation's capital, as all citizens should. It's a great story, and they're a great inspiration to all of us. Thank you.